Microsoft Teams is an effective hub for collaborating, but how can implementing files and links into tabs help us collaborate even more efficiently? As we know, Microsoft Teams is an effective hub for collaboration, not only with chat and voice, but also with sharing information. But once you've started sharing that information, how can you access it quickly, easily, with a limited amount of hassle that will stop you getting waylaid? Well, easiest thing to do is to look at the sort of files that you use on a day-to-day basis and where you can put them. For example, you could use tabs. Now here we are in the collaboration kernel team on the left-hand side, and inside we've got two channels, the general channel that we always have and also the MS Teams channel. So let's consider now how we can add a link to a website. In this case, I think we'll use YouTube, to the tabs at the top of the screen, as you can see that I'm indicating. Now, you've got conversations, you've got wiki, you've got files. Clicking on the plus add a tab sees all the integrations that have been added into Microsoft Teams. And you can pick out things straight away from the Office 365 productivity suite, such as Excel, Word, PowerPoint. And that's great. In addition to all of this, however, there are also other integrations, such as Power BI, YouTube, Microsoft Stream, website links. We're going to go with YouTube just for demonstration, and we're going to make a link to one of my individual videos and not the particular channel. Got a few videos on here. We're going to go for the one that is particularly about how to create a team in Microsoft Teams. We're going to select the link. We're going to click on copy. We're going to go back to Microsoft Teams on the next tab. We're going to paste in that address. Notice HTTPS, and then we're going to click search. Now it finds it by integrating into YouTube. Select the video you want. Now look at the bottom part of that particular pop-out tab. You've got, do you want to post about this in the channel? Now this means, hey, I've uploaded a video. Isn't it fantastic? Look at this, a way of announcing what you're doing to people within that channel. Or you can say, no, I just want to put it in there. I don't want to tell anybody else about it. I don't want to, you know, bring too much attention to it, but I want the information to be there, and then take it off. Okay, with it clicked, it'll make an announcement in the channel. So we're going to click on share, and there it is straight away. It's gone to YouTube, it's pulled up the video, it's integrated it, and you can play it directly within your Teams browser, not having to go out to a web browser to go and watch a video, or not having to go out and look for something. It's all there. Now, if there's a video, for example, say training video on how to fix a broken arm, or how to strap a broken arm, how to put people in the recovery position, how to do something in Concur, how to do something in SAP, you could put it in the top section of your page under, say, a channel called training. We've used how to create a team, for example. Same can be done with documents as well. Again, you can leverage the full Office 365 product in a tab with a Word document, or you can use another website address. So let's take another website address. This could be, say, a link into your intranet for your payroll site. Imagine this, every month you want to download your payslip, because payslips don't get posted to you on paper anymore. You just get an email saying your payslip's available. So you log on to the payroll portal, but to do that, you've got to go to an intranet page. Go to the intranet page, takes you out of the productivity suite, which is the hub of Microsoft Teams, and into another application that's wasting time. You go into that productivity suite, everything's great, you move out of it, you could lose your concentration. So imagine applications of using tabs to intranet websites that you use on a regular basis like this. I mean, I've used Bing as an example, and you'll notice with Microsoft Bing, it comes up straight away, and you've got a web browser then within a channel, but that could quite easily be an intranet page. Look at the other integrations that you can bring in, and then think about how you would design your perfect team for your perfect organization. And then think, well, what do I do on a daily basis? And from that, thinking what jobs you perform on a daily basis, you can then start to affect change for people who work in your organization. For example, here we go. Let's go with another website. Call it good old Star Wars. HTTPS, because it's secure. Colons, the slashes. www.starwars.com. Okay, off it goes, and it brings up Star Wars with all the information on Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker directly in your Teams browser. Again, negating the fact to go out away from that productivity suite and into something else. So that's doing links to videos or the intranet or browsers. That's all well and good. What about files? So here's a file you use on a general basis. I've got a file here. There you go. Nothing particularly fantastic. You can click on the ellipses on the right-hand side and say add as a tab. And you'll notice it's been put as a tab and then opened in Word Online in the Teams browser. You can even edit it there as well. It could be, say, travel documentation. If your travel policies are changing all the time, how would you pin a document to a tab that you know everyone's going to see instantaneously and save you time? It could be your sales spreadsheet. Also, like I said, there's many different ways of putting things into Microsoft Teams and performing certain actions within Microsoft products. Clicking on the plus icon, then clicking on Word as the productivity tool of choice. You can say what you want to name your tab. We'll call it POC for proof of concept. We'll then find a new Word document. We'll go to our test documentation. There's a Word document there, save. And even though I've named the tab something completely different, like proof of concept, the file underneath that is whatever I've chosen it to be. So you could call it sales documentation. You don't really want to call it sales documentation for the quarter one sales meeting. Sales documentation, name of the tab, nice, succinct, acute, to the point. There it is, and there's the information below it. Same with your videos as well. How to fix a broken arm, how to access payroll, how to create a team. I've been the Collaboration Kernel, and thank you very much for watching on how to use tabs and files within Microsoft Teams. Check back for more videos in the series and keep collaborating. I'll see you soon.